Good day, YouTube, and welcome into our Tits Beer Bong 420 wine and beer video, because we're going to review a beer secondly, but first we got these wines to review. Well, maybe reviewed and maybe not, because it's a sampler set of these fortified wines from Portugal. So you get five. They only come in about a shots worth size, so I'm just going to shoot them back. Maybe I'll talk about them. There's five of them. There's two that had to do with white wine, and three that had to do with red. And they just look like three different versions of the same red, because this one name's on the same on every bottle of the reds. So we're going to start with the reds. We have from Beiras Porto, from Portugal. They're 20 red wine. It's 19.5% alcohol. They're just a little sample of them, so just like a shot. Okay, it came out very red, kind of like a cherry color red, a little bit like blood red. Just smells like a red wine. I don't know what else to say. I guess it tastes like red wine, and also it tastes like juice. Now there's a burn from the 19.5%. The alcohol is starting to burn in the throat. Whoops, now it's starting to burn a little in the belly. But at first, it was just almost like a juice taste with a little bit of a wine taste. Then it just, all of a sudden, I got like an alcohol fiery burn in the throat. But not in like a horrible way. That's sort of twiny. This says, or what did it say? T-A-W-N-Y. Yeah, okay. Tawany or whatever. This says reserve on it, so it must be the reserve version. It's another 19.5%. This one, a little bit different, maybe on the coloring of the red. Yeah, a little bit different. Looks a little clearer and maybe a little lighter. Similar smell, so whatever. The reserve version, if that's what this is, it's not as juicy as the original Tawany, I guess, or whatever. This one's more like thicker and heavier, and more like booze, not like, more like your alcohol wine, not like juice. Then we have the 10-year-old version. It gets a 20% alcohol content. Oh, man. With that one, not really burning much. And that burn is really in the throat there, but it's gone down. It's toned down big time. The 10-year-old 20% version. You see what you see. Oh, this is just like a map of South Carolina on this shot glass. Similar smell. Ugh. At 10 years old, with an extra 0.5%, so 20%. Whoa, it's got like you feel a little something like grab you on the sides of your throat with a little bit of a burn. And there's a lot of burn on that one in the belly a bit, but lightly. It's kind of like a combination of the other first two. Yeah. If you like red wine, stronger kicks. Now the other two before the beer review, folks. We've got ourselves, just this one, it just says white. 19.5%. Smells like a white wine, so I mean, it's got a little bit of a sweetness, wine style, white wine style sweetness. Kind of seems a little spicy and floral. Cheers. Huh. Seems like a little bit more to take in, and a little tiny difficult to take that one in, but just a stronger white wine without really any flavor, and just a typical white wine but with a lot of strongness. Holy fuck, on the buzz coming in. Son of a bitch. And then we got the last one here, folks. Lagrima, Lagrima, Bronco White. It's another 19.5%. So only that 20% one was for the 10-year-old. Everything else was 19.5%. These are Portugal wines. It's another white one. It's kind of got like a buttery, toffee smell a bit. Maybe a caramel smell. I swear it smells a little something like that. I would not expect that to go with that white wine sweetness. Don't ask me why, but I just felt like there was more to take in of the white wines. And just a little bit of almost like a... That one's almost like a dessert. It's got a little bit of like a biscotti kind of taste to it. Okay, thank you for staying tuned in. Now we got a beer to review here from Innocent Gun. It's their Oloroso cask. It's a beer that was in barrels that had a Oloroso sherry at one point. It's a special kind of sherry from Spain. Like the flavoring is really, really like awesome for like whiskeys and beers, and people love using it. And it was rare and a little bit hard for them to get some barrels, but they got, I think, like 300 that they got to use for the world. Let's just say here, this bottle comes from a select batch of only 300 barrels, 7.4% alcohol. Oloroso is a type of fortified wine from Spain. It means scented in Spanish. It has a rich quality. They're highly praised by Scotch whiskey distilleries. Mature to spirits in them. They're talking about how they're lucky enough to have gotten their hands on some. This beer is unmarkable, adding many layers of depth and complexity. It uses ale malt that the Innocent Gunner used and their crystal malt. It helps to give a signature sweet maltiness to the backbone. They use English fugal hops to give an earthy bitterness and light aroma. The casks that they use give it a bittersweet richness and complexity. Talking about how it's good to sip it with your friends over on a hot summer's day, but it's out now. Anyways, here you go. Long ass video. And I'm definitely not sober in the video. Oh, like a buttery toffee smell. Almost like a shortbread cookie with some wine sweetness and the oak barrels. Smells really good. Cheers. If you can hear the tunes in the background or listening to recent spangled music. And that was a horrible fucking pour. Man, I poured how many beers before? Sometimes bad pours. But it's got almost like a lager look to it. Golden carbonated ale. Little chunks of carbonation from here and again going up. Not a lot though. In the glass, a different smell than the bottle. It's got like butter smell. It's got the barrel smell for sure, for sure, for sure. It's a little hard to explain. It's honestly, it's almost like a shortbread cookie smell, like some butter, some shortbread cookie smell, a little bit like a gingerbread cookie smell without the ginger. I smell the barrel. I smell spiciness. I smell sweetness of the wine. Things like that. It smells interesting and good. 7.4% Urdor. The Oloroso cast. It's like a basic malty innocent gun ale. With like a biscuit sweetness and bite to it, but then the wine part to it just brings in this sweetness that's rough a little, and I got a little bit of like a gross booziness in the belly, and it's heavy bodied, but I mean it's like a nice malty innocent gun ale with like a sweet biscuity bite and taste, like a little bit of a toffee cookie thing. Both a bit of like a fiery warmth, a little bit of like a spice. I mean, the ale tastes nice, but the wine part, a little grossness to it. Meh on it, I would say. And I know I'm not doing a super good review on it. But, you know, you can really taste the wine, you can really taste the barrels, and the ale's like a sweet biscuit. And the ale's nice. The wine part's a little, slight little grossness. You gotta remember everything else before the beer review. I'm not sober. Peace out.